The fierce and aggressive, double-sworded warrior, famous and legendary Oghuz nobleman. Hilarious and kind-hearted, handsome and generous by nature, Bamsi Beyrek. Bamsi was a legendary hero whose life was documented in the Book of Dede Korkut, which is believed to have been over thousands of years old. Bamsi was said to have been the best friend of the main character in the book, Salur Kazan. However, what do we know about the life of the Oghuz legend, Bamsi Beyrek? Many thousands of years ago, there was a grand gathering of all princes in the presence of Bayandirhan, the Aqayunnu Sultan. Upon seeing that every other nobleman had a son beside him, one of the princes, Baybur, started to weep. One of the noblemen, Salur Kazan, who happened to be the son-in-law of Bayandirhan, asked him, "Why do you weep?" Baybur replied, telling them he did not have a son or brother to carry on his family. And so, all the Oghuz princes prayed that he would get a son, and luckily for Beybur, their prayers were accepted, and he soon got the children he wished to have. One of his children's names would be Bamsi. However, Beybur was overjoyed to have his wish come true, and so he summoned his merchants and ordered them to go on a journey to the lands of Rum and bring them back fine gifts before his son would reach the age of maturity. 16 years later, Bamsi, the son of Beybur, who had become a gallant young man, went out hunting. Whilst he was resting after the hunt, merchants came running to him. They explained that they had been away from the lands of the Oghuz for 16 years and that they had returned with various goods from Rum. Though, just as they were about to enter Oghuz territory, they exclaimed, "We were ambushed and plundered by 500 infidels from Evnik Castle. Our brothers have been taken as prisoners and our goods have all been stolen. Afflicted with this misfortune, we come to you for help." And so Bamsi, who had but 40 warriors with him, stood up and got ready for battle. Whilst the enemies were busy dividing their spoils, Bamsi and his men pounced upon them, striking fear in the hearts of the enemies. And so, Bamsi and his 40 men had astonishingly defeated the army and saved the goods. The merchants were so pleased with the young prince that they offered him to take whichever good he liked. Of all the fabulous luxuries they had brought, only the horse, bow, and arrows attracted Bamsi's attention. However, he noticed that the merchants showed discomfort in his wish. And so he told them, "Oh merchants, did I ask too much?" The men replied, "It is not that. Our prince has a son, and we must take those three articles to him as gifts." Bamsi then asked, "Who is the son of your prince?" The merchants replied, "He is Bamsi, the son of Beybur." And so the young prince told himself, "I'd rather have my father give such things to me than beg them from these men." Bamsi then whipped his horse and rode back to his father's camp. The father of Bamsi, Beybur, rejoiced upon hearing of the merchant's return. And so, as the merchants entered his tent, they immediately kissed the hands of Bamsi, who happened to be sitting next to his father. Beybur shouted at them, "You kiss the son's hands first while the father is beside him?" Stunned, the merchants replied, "My prince, do not be offended that we kissed his hand first. For had it not been for him, our goods would have been taken to Georgia and all of us would have been captives." Astonished by the feats accomplished by Bamsi, Beybur invited all the powerful Oghuz princes as his guests, and it would be then and there that Dede Korkut himself would give him his full name, Bamsi Beyrek. Soon after that, Bamsi Beyrek would be engaged to the daughter of Beybiçin, Benuçiçek. However, not long after, him and his 40 warriors would be ambushed and taken prisoners by the lord of Beybiçin's castle and his 700 men. And so, for 16 years, Bamsi would remain in a prison cell of the castle. However, he would eventually escape with the help of the daughter of the landlord, who had fallen in love with him. He would return to his people and marry his betrothed, Benuçiçek. Many years later, a civil war broke out between the inner and outer Oghuz tribes. Though Bamsi was from the inner Oghuz, his wife, Benuçiçek, was from the outer Oghuz. However, Bamsi remained loyal to the ruler of the Oghuz Turks, Salur Kazan, who also happened to be a dear friend of his. Seeing that Bamsi refused to rebel against the ruler, the chief of the outer Oghuz rebels, Uruz Koca, treacherously killed Beyrek, marking the end of the Oghuz legend, Bamsi Beyrek. His fame spread all throughout the world, and his legends were told for centuries. His grave is in the village of Irinli, in Beybur, Turkey. He likely will never be forgotten.